Morning students, how are you all? Hope you are doing good at home and you are fine. So, we have started chapter 6, that is integers, and we have completed exercise 6.1. Now, let's understand some more topics like how we do addition with the help of a number line. Okay? Now, as you all know that on the number line we are having on the left hand side negative integers, on the right hand side positive integers. Okay? Now here I have given a question that is +5 + +2. Okay, here both integers are positive. Okay, so what we will do first, there are two methods how we can do. First we will put the point on 5. Okay, here it is +2. So we will move in the right direction by 2 digits. So 1, 2. So where we have reached? Yes, we have reached 7. So +5 + 2 will give you +7. Okay, understood? In the same way, we are given another example: -5 + -2. So here it is -2. So on the number line we have to see where -2 is given, and then +-2. Okay, +-. So we have to move two numbers on the left. Okay, so 1, 2. So where we have reached? -7. So -2 + -2 -5 + -2 will give you -7. Okay, in this way we do addition on the number line. Now let's see how we can do subtraction on the number line. Now here, subtraction using number lines. So here I have taken an example: +4 - +3. Okay, here we can write it as it is same as +4 + -3. Now how we get this +4 + -3? By changing the digits here. If it is minus, we can do plus, and if it is plus, we can convert it into minus. So here it is minus, so we have changed it to plus, and here it is plus, we have changed it to minus. So now, first step what we will do, here +4. +4 means from 0, we will take this arrow till 4. Okay? Here it is 4, so we have started from 0, we have reached 4. Now it is -3. So what we have to do, -3 means we have to move to the negative side, that is left side. So from here we will move 3 positions to the left. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, where we have reached? Yes, we have reached 1. So here the answer is 1. Okay, in the same way there is one more example: -4 - -3. Now here also, to make it simple, what we will do, we will change the sign. So here it is minus, so it will become plus. Here it is minus, it will become plus. So first foremost thing what we will do, we will start with 0 to minus 4. Okay, we have reached here -4. Now what we have to do? ++3. If +3 means we have to move 3 position to the right side. Okay? So from here we will take 3 position to the right side. So 1, 2, and 3. Okay? So then we have reached -1. So here we got the answer as -1. Okay? In this way, we can do addition and subtraction using number lines. Now there is another method also, that is absolute method. So let's see that absolute method. Now here, addition using absolute value. As you all know, absolute value is what? It is geometrically symbolized as this. Okay? Now, if any number is having negative sign, then absolute value will be the positive one. Okay? So, here by using that positive value or the absolute value, we have to find the addition. So, here I have taken an example where both the numbers, both the integers are positive integers. So, plus 23 and plus 25. So, what we have to do? We have to just simplify, just add them, as simple as that, and the sign will be positive. Okay? So, plus 23 plus 25 is equal to 58 and the sign will be plus. Okay? Now the same way, another example, one negative and another also negative. So two negative integers. So what we will do is that absolute value will be added and the prefix will be negative. Okay? The prefix will be minus sign, because the greater one is having a minus sign, 24 is having minus sign, so we will put minus sign here and we will add it. Okay? 24 plus 21 will give you minus 55. Okay, understood? Now, in the same way, we are having another example, that is plus 23 plus of minus 15. Okay, so here both the integers are having opposite signs. So what we will do? We will first take out their absolute value. So what is the absolute value of 23? Is 23. Absolute value of minus 15 is 15. So now what you will see that which is the greatest number? The greatest number is 23. What sign it is having? Positive sign. So what we will do? We will put the positive sign. Plus minus. Minus. So 23 minus 15. Okay. Answer is 8. And the prefix is plus. So we will put this. Okay, why plus? Because the integer here, the greatest integer is having positive sign. Same thing you can do with the example, like if a greater number is having a negative sign, then the answer will also have a negative sign. So these were three types of addition and subtraction using number line, and third method was addition using absolute value. So we have covered a topic in it. In the chapter integer, we will meet tomorrow. Till then, take care, goodbye, thank you.